This is Josh Olmsted. Welcome to Northwest Disc Golf's coverage of the first ever Northwest Amateur Championships presented by Innova. On the card today, we have Cory Jones from Auburn, Washington, Jacob Dills from Hillsboro, Oregon, Mike Mayer from Tumwater, Washington, and Michael Henson from Elma, Washington. All four of these guys are top-notch Northwest advanced players playing some A-tier action, one of the biggest advanced fields in all of the Northwest this year. Glad you could join us at the Shelton Springs Disc Golf Course. This is a fantastic course, playing from the black tees this round. If you watched last round, it was from the shorter red tees. So this time you'll get to see the course in all of its might. So up first, we have Cory.
Cory Harrison, Vincent Jones, PDGA number 59870.
Cory's throwing an X1 from Prodigy. Hole one here is pretty straight, a little bit of a dog leg left, pretty tight all the way to the pin. Definitely a hole these guys are going to want to get a birdie on, because there aren't a lot of easy birdie ups on this black tee layout. Nice shot there from Jacob.
Michael Henson, 7-4, 8-9-8.
Michael's up third. All these guys taking the backhand hyzer route. Michael gets caught up about halfway down.
Mike Mayer, number 7-2-8-7-9.
Looks like Mike might have had some first tee jitters there. He'll get to take a second from just about the same spot.
There you go.
I was lucky enough to get a chance to talk with one of the two TDs of this event, Morgan Rothrock. He's the president of the Maison County Disc Golf Club. They're the team that helped put in this fantastic course. I've had a chance to play here a few times myself. This is a real amazing, great putt from Cory. I think we're going to need to see that again on replay. Cans a 60-footer. Great way to start any round. Jacob follows it up with the birdie as well. See if Mike can recover from that first drive. He's taking a bogey. So to give a little background on this event, these guys are playing for one of the biggest amateur prizes in all of disc golf. I haven't heard of anything quite like this. They're playing for a all expenses paid trip to Toboggan, Michigan for the United States Amateur Disc Golf Championships for them and a caddy. Giving one local player a chance at the tournament of a lifetime. Hole two, we've got 345 feet, par three, dog leg left. We've got to play out of a really tight window, the first 150 feet out into an open field. I think the important thing on this hole is really making sure that you clear that first window, because this hole gets really hard if you're not out there in the field. Jacob takes care of that, just getting out. It'll be a long upshot for his second. Fourth, does a good job recovering from that bogey on one. He's gonna have the closest putt out of the group. He's just gonna try to get out with an overhand. Oh, and he manages to get up and have a putt. That is a great escape. Talking with the TD, he was talking about how they've been running, you know, some big professional tournaments out here in Maison County, but there really weren't any local players who were, you know, at that pro level, really, or who were going to be competing for the first place prize. It tended to be touring pros, and you know, they told me that they'd spent all this time, you know, trying to attract one or two touring pros, and this year they really wanted to focus on the AM players in the region, really make this part of a sort of a developmental tournament, help get these guys, some of these local guys, prepared to become touring pros as the community grows stronger in this part of the state. Shelton really came out of nowhere to be one of the top courses in Washington. It's only 5 years old, 2011, and it's already really taken on a level of prestige in the region. So he wanted a real championship level amateur event, really help show this community that, you know, this is the future of disc golf, is the amateur players. So Cory takes a five, gives Jacob the lead after two holes. Everyone else taking pars as we move on to hole three. Hole three, we finally get to see the full scope of how big this course really is. In round two, this is only 660 feet from the black tees. It is 965 feet, the longest hole on the course. It's a par five. Takes two really big drives, and there's a lot of wind out here. You start to hear it blowing up. Takes two really good drives. You can see that little white circle down there is kind of what they're aiming for. It's about a 50-foot wide window, and you really want to get your second shot into that window because it is some nasty trees on either side of the landing area. Once you're there, it's another 280 feet down a tight tunnel to get to the basket. Mike looks like he's going to be flirting with the road. Let's see if that gets down in bounds. Cory with the standing drive. He's throwing a D1 on that shot. So he's a prototype test D1. It's a little bit more understable. Looks like Mike ended up safe here on the right. He's just getting back into the fairway. Jacob crushed a huge drive on the first throw. He'll end up sort of at the outer edge of that window. Henson, he's going to try to give it a go, and you can see that's what happens on this hole. You really get in trouble in those bushes if you try to go for it on the second shot and don't make it in there. Mike's got really crazy snap there. Really gives a, puts a lot on the disc. Jacob still managing to really navigate this hole well. He might be one of the only people with a chance at birdie at this hole. Cory with the forehand shot. Oh, he gets a nice kick. It's keeping him from drifting right. You can see in here, you know, there are paths through these trees, but pretty much anywhere you're going to have to navigate some amount of trees on this course. Definitely a lot of what adds is challenge. Shelton doesn't have as much in the way of elevation or lakes, but they rely on this beautiful forest to provide all the challenge the course needs.
Attaboy.
Attaboy. Jacob for his par. Cory just chaining out. That Discraft Chainstar basket didn't want to hold it in there. Michael wraps up what I believe to be the only par on the card. The rest of the group will tap out bogeys. Hole three beats up on the group, leaving Jacob with a one-stroke lead. Cory and Michael are tied just one back as we move on to hole four. Hole four is 340-foot par four, but on these thick woods on the front nine, it's just going to feel a lot longer than 340. Really a challenging hole to get. It's only 285 from the red tees, but this takes a really technical laser shot to get it up there, and Mike is going to have a hard time getting out of there. It's a great forehand from Jacob. Mike going with a tomahawk, I believe. I believe he's throwing a Firebird. I think that was actually a thumber shot. Mike told me he throws a flat-top Firebird for all of his thumbers, and he throws a tremendous amount of overhand. He's got one of the best I've seen. Cory there throwing a team stamp Prodigy M4. It's an understable mid-range. You can see it is a really hard time on this course as soon as you leave the fairway. Michael does a good job just doing damage control, keeping it to a bogey. But I do have to say, and you'll notice, the course is incredibly well-groomed. The fairways, very little debris, beautiful tee pads, beautiful tee signs. Oh, and Cory sinks a great birdie putt. Good way to recover after a 6 on the par 5, showing off his plastic. Rest of the group will clean up. So after hole 4, we've got Cory tying the lead with Jacob at 8 under. And we know, these guys know they have to play well because there is a lot of guys right behind them on the chase card. It was a really wild second round. All 4 of these guys on the card shot better than 980 rated rounds. I believe one of them shot a 1008 rated round, which was a 10 under. Jacob shot a 10 under par in the second round. Cory throwing a sidearm with his Prodigy X1. Jacob manages to get out there. Great forehand. Setting himself up well on this par 4. There's a lot of these tough par 4s, and it's hard enough to throw a 550-foot hole, but when you have to navigate this many trees, it makes it a lot harder. Talking with the tournament director, he was one of the people who helped set up this course. He really wanted to make a course that would stand as a long-term challenge, something that local players could really improve their game year after year, you know, not a course that you can sort of figure out all the lines.
Yeah, you got some tree love too.
Get really low under par rounds, something that could really grow the game, especially since there weren't a lot of courses in this part of Washington. It's still the only course for about 45 minutes in any direction. Here's Mike with another beautiful overhand shot that is parked. Said for his tomahawks, he's throwing a 145 gram destroyer. Really, probably part of why he can throw it so hard. Really lightweight disc for that shot. Here's Jacob with a long birdie putt, just a little short. Nice par. Definitely a good score on this hole. Not going to be a lot of birdies in this field. But Mike gets it with the back-to-back overhand. Great birdie for Mike. Trying to get back up towards the lead. Definitely a tournament where it's not quite winner takes all. There's script for everyone else, but certainly they're chasing that top prize. So hole 6, we've got a 320-foot par 3, dogleg left with a very protected green. That could be first on the pad. Trying to go for that laser flip, doesn't look like it links up quite. Cory throwing a special edition F2 overstable fairway disc.
Oh yeah. No sound.
Oh, and that is parked. That is the shot of the round so far. Great birdie. Cory told me that he's been working on that standstill drive for quite a while. He started out doing the run-up, and he had a lot of power really early on, but he just didn't feel the control, and he He says he can get to 400 on a standstill, so if you can throw it that far without a run-up, you might as well do it. I struggle to throw 350 with a full run-up. Nice shot there from Mike. Jacob going for the long birdie. Tails out a little bit early. Michael from the bushes. Just lay up. Mike to break the par streak. Oh! Nails the basket. He's lucky that sat right down next to the pin. It looks like he's disappointed to miss that one. So I believe that's pars for the card. As we move on to hole 7. Oh, I take it back. Cory with that. Oh yeah, with that birdie. Just a 4-foot tapper. So we move on to hole 7. Cory takes a couple of strokes, puts some separation on the group at 9 under par, putting himself in good place 1/3 of the way through the round. Hole 7, this hole is a lot harder from the black tees. If you watched the second round, it was only 275 feet. This round, it's 400 feet, making it one of the longer par 3s. Once again, you've got a tight fairway to start, but it opens back up into that big field about 30 feet in front of the pin. There is a 20-foot wide strip of out of bounds that these guys are going to avoid. You can see those red stakes sort of mark a river in front of the hole. Makes it difficult to run at the hole, but looks like Mike's going to give it a go with that forehand roller. Brave shot. Can it clear it? He rolls back and out of bounds. Really tough break there for Mike. That was a great attempt. I don't think I've ever seen that hole thrown with a forehand roller. Cory will join him. Forehand roller, escape shot. He lays up just short of the out of bounds though. Another long putt for his par. I believe that was Jacob. The backhand, he gets it all the way up there. Great shot. Cory putting with his PA3s. Says he carries a stack of them on the course. Cory recently sponsored with Prodigy on the street team. He's just, all these guys are right about 950. And you can tell with these guys shooting 980s and 990s in the second round that these are the type of players that anytime they can go off and shoot a really low score. Clean up. Exciting to see that the future pros of the Northwest on display. That was a rough hole for this group. 3 bogeys and 1 par for Michael. Definitely that OB long par 3. Big challenge. So hole 8, we've got another big par 4. 565 feet from the black tees. Really solid par if you can get it. One of my favorite holes out here.
They got out.
Yeah, buddy.
A couple of good, safe placement shots, and it's not too hard a par, but you really need to lace some accurate straight drives if you want to have a chance at birdie. The goal is to position yourself as well as you can out in this clearing to have a good chance to get down the alley. It's definitely a hole that rewards smart golf, placement golf. Definitely one of the strong aspects of the course out here in Shelton, there really aren't any throwaway shots. You really have to be consistent on point throughout the round. Trying to lace a forehand up the alley. There it goes, overhand. A lot of fun overhand shots today. Busting out the baseball pitch. He's just happy to be safe there. As he goes with another one of those snappy thumbers.
Yeah.
That Firebird. Working well for him today. He's getting rewarded. Definitely a versatile shot if you have it in the bag. Definitely good to see a nice wide variety of shots from this group. Forehand, backhand, overhand. Gets it. Great save. Definitely a hole that par feels like an achievement. Cory just misses wide. As Michael cleans up. Mike saves his four. Great four from Mike. Cory will clean up his bogey as the sole bogey on the card, so gets close again. Michael with one stroke behind Cory going into that last hole of the front nine. Mike and Jacob are a few strokes back of that. Definitely going to need to get some birdies if they want to stay ahead of the chase card. Hole 9, 285 feet, par 3. This is one of the holes that not too different from the red tee distance. Michael's up first. Backhand. Great shot. Mike's throwing his white rock. Older DX rock. That's flipping nicely. Beautiful shot. You can't play it much better than that. The classic tunnel shot. How straight can you throw a disc? Cory throwing his 750 PA4 understable prodigy putter. He and that long chance just over the top. He's had a lot of good runs this nine, but doesn't seem to make any of those longer putts. Mike does a good job grabbing that birdie. Cory makes a great comebacker for par. As does Jacob. And Mike with the 2 foot drop in. Great way to end the front nine. Give yourself a little momentum. So at the end of nine holes, Mike and Jacob are tied at 5 under. Cory is now in second with a 6 under, and Michael Henson leads it at 7 under par. If you enjoyed our video, please don't forget to subscribe. Give us a thumbs up on the video. We've got some great coverage of the Fort Stilicum Open, A-Tier, Tacoma, and the Disco Ball down in Oregon. Make sure to catch all of our fantastic disc golf action as we continue to cover all the Northwest's best events.